Hello everyone, welcome back to CAD Tutorials for Beginners. In this tutorial we will learn the draft command in CATIA V5, so again which is one of the dressup features in CATIA V5. And if you see the dressup feature toolbar, you can see we have already seen the different types of edge, different types of fillets, edge fillet, then the variable radius fillet and so on. After that we have seen the chamfer, shell, then thickness and the thread type definition. So in this tutorial, let's discuss about the draft command in CATIA V5. So there are three types of draft in CATIA. So first one is the constant draft, second one is the variable draft, and the third one is draft with a reflect line. So if you click on this drop down, you can see these three types over here. The first is the draft angle, which is a combination of draft as well as the constant as well as the variable draft angle. Second one is a draft reflect line, and the third one is again the same as the first one, that is a draft angle, which is a variable angle draft. So if you click on it, you can see there are two types of draft here. The first one is the constant and second one is the variable draft. So in this we need to provide the draft angle, the faces to draft, the neutral element and the pulling direction. The other, if you see here, other are the elements or the parameters we can provide depending upon the design requirement. So the first point is the most important, like the draft face, which is parallel to the tooling direction. And the second one is the neutral face, where the section remains the same and there are no dimension changes on that face, and from which the draft starts or ends. The third one is the pulling direction. So pulling direction defines how the part should be pulled out of the mold and which is perpendicular to the neutral face. The fourth point is the parting line, which is the broadest zone of the part, and it is a line joining the two molds, not two molds, which is the upper half and the lower half, like the cope and drag molds. So let's understand with the help of example. So we have just created this object over here, which is a rectangular block. And here we will provide the draft to that part. So let's click on the draft definition and we'll keep this constant for the first time. So here by default the angle is 5 degrees, and the draft angle is basically depends upon the material which we have used and which lies in the range of 1 to 5 degrees. So let's select the faces to draft. So I will just select this face to draft here, and after that we'll provide the neutral element. So again, neutral element is the face for which there are no dimension changes here and from which the draft starts. So once you click on the neutral face, the pulling direction is automatically selected in CATIA V5, and you can see the draft angle is applied here as 5 degrees. So you can change that angle here as well. Let's change it to 4 degrees, and once you click on the preview, you can see the draft angle is added. So again, you can add multiple faces over here. So just select the faces to draft. I will select these faces to draft. Just click on OK. So once you click on it, you can see the two faces for which the draft is applied. So let's try changing this angle. I will just change it to 10 for the illustration purpose, and you can see the angle is changed for the draft. So you can again modify by double clicking on that option in this specification tree. So again, I will just double click on it and I will remove the second face added. Just remove it, and here in the more option, we'll see one more option available, that is a limiting element. So like what we have seen in the fillets, we can apply the limiting elements here as well. So let's say if you want to provide the draft for the specific region or on that face, then we can use up these limiting elements. So we'll just create the two planes. Just create a plane and select this face over here and just make it to 25. And similarly, I will create one more plane on the other side just create a plane, select this as a reference plane in the reverse direction and click on OK. So again, I will just change the direction and I want a draft between these two arrows. So you can see here the red line showing that the draft will applied over here only, on this region only. And once you click on preview, just click on OK. So you can see that the draft is applied between these two planes only, which you have created for the illustration purpose. So this is the limiting element which we can use depending upon our requirement. So again, double click on it and I will just remove this, just clear the selection and click on preview. So now we have seen this constant type, which is a one-sided draft. And here you can see, if you click on OK, you can select the neutral line, neutral element over here if you want to create a both side draft. Once you click on parting equal to neutral, you can have this option available, that is draft two sides. And just I will just make it uncheck here, and we'll first understand this one-sided draft only. And now we are going to see the variable draft. So once you click on the variable draft, again the options are same, only here there is one option getting added here, the variable points, which we have seen in the variable radius fillet. So here we can add multiple points inside on this edge. Just select the point, select the points over here, select this point, and you can change this angle, let's say 5 degrees. Here I will change it to 6 degrees, let's say 7 degrees, and here I will add it to 8 degrees, and again click on preview, just click on OK. So now you can see the difference, the variable radius draft is applied and the angle you can see here, it is variable. So this is the only difference between the constant type and the variable type. You can add the different angle, variable angle, with this variable draft type. So you can just select the propagation at smooth, just click on OK. The propagation will be smooth if you select the propagation type as smooth. So again, double click on it and click on the more option. Again, you can see the similar options available as the limiting elements over here. And just cancel it. So now let's delete this one. And now we'll make some changes over here. Let's add a mirror extent and click on OK. Now we will see the both sided draft over here. Again, click on the draft option and here select the faces to draft. Again, I will select this face as to draft. Again, select this face, or just for the illustration, we'll just keep this first one only now, as of now. And here the neutral element, will select this as a neutral element and click on the more option. So actually we'll just change this neutral element to this plane over here, and we'll make this plane as a neutral element. And let's click on the preview, click on OK. So now you can see there is only one sided draft is again added over here. If you want the double sided draft, you can go to the more option and just click on the parting equal to neutral and click on the draft both sides. So once you click on preview and click on OK, you can see here the draft is applied on the both the sides. And again, in the specification tree, you can see the different symbol available here with two types of draft. Draft to the both the sides. So again, I will select the all the faces, just select all the faces over here and click on OK. So in this way you can add the both side draft in CATIA v5. So now let's move on to the another option, that is the draft with a reflect line. So again, I will not delete this, just deactivate this option. And now let's go to the draft with a reflect line. So here, to apply the draft with a reflect line, we need to have the fillet for the edge of the face for which we need to provide the draft, this type of draft. Okay, so let's add the fillet over here. I will just add fillets to all the faces. I will delete this. Again, first time we will see only this face here, and click on the draft with the reflect line and select this face to provide the select the fillet face over here and click on preview. And once you click on preview, you can see the draft is applied for that face. So now let's apply this fillet, edge fillet, for all the edges. Just select these three more edges over here and click on OK. And again, click on the draft option. And here we will select the another fillet faces as well. Just select this face and this face. And once you click on OK, you can see the draft is applied with a reflect line for all these faces. So in this way, you can understand the draft in CATIA v5. So thank you for watching this video. Hope you have enjoyed watching it, and thank you so much.